Dear children, hope you all are doing well and staying home. And today we are going to study the lesson, The 100 Dresses, Part 1. This story is actually divided in two parts. We are going to do the first part now. And let's see how this story unfolds, what this whole story is about. And before we proceed, let's know a little bit about author. The author of this story is Eleanor Estes. She was born in 1906 and she died in 1988. She was actually a librarian, children's librarian for many years, and she started her writing career with the publication of The Moffats, a very famous story in 1941. Two of her books about the Moffats are Newbery Honor Book, and one of them is The 100 Dresses. She won the Newbery Medal for Ginger Pie in 1952. And in 1952, when she wrote the book Ginger Pie, she won the Newbery Medal for that. So that she was a very versatile author also. And let's find out what she has written in this story. And she was basically, she used to write children's stories only. And this is one of the stories that you'll find very interesting stories, story that is also for children only. Before we start, let's know a little bit. Know a little bit about this chapter. This whole chapter, The 100 Dresses, first is about a girl whose name is Wanda Petronsky, and who actually claims to have 100 dresses at her house, but everybody makes fun of that. Thing that whenever she says that I am having 100 dresses at my house, all lined up in my closet, then all the students, they used to make fun of her. Why they used to make fun of her? Because if she had 100 dresses, then why was she wearing just a single dress every day and just the same dress every day? And then perhaps she is lying. Her classmates made fun of her every day, and it was because there was another reason of making fun of her, that was her name, because most of the students in the class, they had easier names, and Wanda was not such a name that they came across quite often. Wanda Petronsky, something like that, they have never heard. Like in your classes, you'll find Suraj, you'll find Rahul, you'll find Sonia, you'll find Sania, you'll find several names like that, you'll find Siddhant. But suppose somebody comes like Murugan Appa and somebody with a very different name, then what will happen? You will feel like, how come such a name could be given to a person? So that was something like that on over there also with Wanda Petronsky. Most of the children, they were aware of Alex, they were aware of George, but they had never heard a name something like Wanda Petronsky. So that is why she made fun of her name. And why was her name very different? Because she was a Polish girl. Who is a Polish? Polish means somebody who has come from Poland, an immigrant. Immigrant, actually, here you can see a word, immigrant. This word has two variants of this word. One is emigrant, A-E-M-I, that is E-M-I-G-R-A-N-T, and this one is I-M-M-I-G-R-A-N-T. Immigrant means someone who comes from another country to a country. So in that country, that person becomes immigrant. And when someone goes from his or her own country outside, then for their own country, they become emigrant. So she was an immigrant from Poland, who had come to America, and definitely where she had come to America, American town, with her family. She was poor. Another thing was that she was a poor girl, did not have many friends, and she was quiet and was always seen sitting in the corner of the classroom. And there was a few more things about her, that she was a poor girl also, and she did not have so many friends in the class. And she used to be little quiet also. She used to be very quiet. She did not used to speak anything to the whole class. She never spoke anything. And that was another reason that made actually everybody believe that she is not going to say anything, so they can bully her. The truth about the 100 dresses unveiled with this when she submitted her drawings, 100 drawings in a drawing contest. And when everybody actually they made fun of her, the idea that she was having 100 dresses, when a drawing competition was organized in the school and she submitted 100 drawings of different colorful dresses, and then everybody was really astonished to see that she really had 100 dresses, but it was actually in the form of drawings. They were the same 100 dresses, and whatever she used to describe, that I have this one blue in color, this one pink in color, so whatever the color combination, whatever the design pattern that she used to describe to them, the very design and the very color combination was there in her drawings. She used to talk about all of them were immensely beautiful, and when she exhibited all her work in the class, everybody was astonished to see it, everybody was surprised to see it, and everybody was admiring her also, that wow, really she was having 100 dresses and she was not lying. Now let's find out the summary of this story. This whole story is about a quiet and shy girl. As I have told you all, this story is about a girl whose name is Wanda Petronsky, who is a police girl. Police girl means what? As I already told you, that someone who has come from Poland. And who is an immigrant? Immigrant is a person who comes from another country to a country. And when you leave your country, you become emigrant. E-M-I. Emigrant for your country and immigrant to the country where you go. So she had come to America with her family, and there she started attending American school. Definitely, if you are living in America, definitely you have to go to American school only. So she started going to an American school, and she when everybody got to know that her name was Wanda Petronsky, then they started making fun of her because they had never come across such a name quite often, and they were very much acquainted with, they were very much known to names such as Alex, such as George, such as you must have heard several names like that. So that was the thing, that is why most of the children they started making fun of her. The weirdest in the classroom, this is because they all had, and she actually, her name was they found that her name was the weirdest in the class. Weirdest means what? Something that is so strange. Weirdest is what? Something that is so strange. So they found that her name was so weird, so strange, and that is why they used to make fun. This is because they all had easy names. She was poor and was always seen wearing a faded blue dress. She was very poor, and every day she used to come in the same dress, that was a blue color dress, and it was faded. Its color was also faded. Her classmates teased her because she claimed to have 100 dresses all lined up in her closet, albeit always being seen wearing one. So what happened when any of them would ask her, Wanda, how many dresses do you have? Whole game was started by Maddie and Peggy. Somehow this whole idea came into Peggy's mind. Peggy was a very beautiful girl and very intelligent girl of the class, and Maddie was her best friend. So this whole idea of asking the dress game came into Peggy's mind. One day she asked her that how many dresses, that why is she wearing this single dress. She actually wanted to ask her that why is she wearing this single dress only, but instead of asking this, she asked her, Wanda, how many dresses do you have? And then Wanda gave a very surprising reply to her, and that was, she is having 100 dresses at her house, all lined up in her closet. And that's how this whole thing began, the teasing game began, and everybody started teasing her. Everybody used to ask her, Wanda, how many dresses do you have? Mostly this whole thing was actually asked by Peggy and Maddie. Maddie did not used to say anything to her, but Peggy used to ask her, that Wanda, she used to ask her in a very mocking voice, Wanda, how many dresses do you have? Then she used to reply, I have 100 dresses all lined up in my closet. This one is blue in color. This was in peacock green in color. So she used to describe all those things every day. And then after that, they used to laugh at her. So this was the whole routine they all had started. Her classmates teased her because she claimed to have 100 dresses all lined up in her closet, albeit. Albeit means what? Although, if it though, always being seen wearing one. Albeit is a conjunction, and this one I have shared as word of the day also. You can go and find out the video for that thing also. Always being seen wearing one. She because every day she used to wear just one dress only, and she claimed to have that she was having 100 dresses. The ones who mainly teased her were the two best friends. As I've told you, the ones who mainly teased her were two best friends, Peggy and Maddie. Peggy was the most famous girl in school, while anyone barely knew Wanda. There was another thing. Peggy was very famous, but anyone barely knew who was Wanda Petronsky. Peggy and Maddie used to wait for Wanda before school, even if it meant getting late. And for this teasing game, every day Peggy and Maddie used to wait for Wanda at the street only, corner of the street only. Why they used to wait? Because in the school premises, they did not get time to tease her. So they used to tease her outside also. And sometimes when they were actually in the yard, they were playing, they were having some free time. At that time also, they used to tease her. So they used to start this game in the morning itself. Whenever they used to come to school, on the way only, they used to wait for Wanda Petronsky, and when they saw her, they started teasing her. And even if they became late, so that was also fine with them, they used to wait for her. Maddie, a poor girl herself, did not like when Peggy made fun of Wanda. Though Maddie was a very good friend of Peggy, Maddie was always there with her, but she was herself a poor girl. So whenever Peggy used to tease Wanda Petronsky, at that time she did not used to feel good for that. She used to feel very sad for Wanda, and she felt perhaps Peggy would stop it one day, and perhaps Peggy will not make fun of her, because this is something that actually should not be done, because poorness is something that should not be made fun of. And but she was not able to oppose it. She never opposed it. She feared that she could be next, because she had the same fear that if she said to Peggy, suppose that Peggy, you must not tease Wanda, then she would say why, and then she would perhaps one day ask her that why, how many dresses do you have, Peggy? Then perhaps she would be her next target, and perhaps she would start asking to her the same game, and then perhaps she is not like Wanda, and she would not tell a lie, and she will tell the truth. And she will also tell the truth that the dresses that she is wearing is one of Peggy's dresses only, that was cleverly stitched by her mother, and that was actually disguised. She wanted Peggy to stop making fun of Wanda. She wanted it, felt like she must stop it. And even she decided to write a letter to Peggy, that Peggy, you must stop making fun of Wanda. But after writing for a while, she just came across this idea that perhaps if she did not like this, and perhaps she stopped Wanda Petronsky teasing, and then after that she started teasing her, then she would become the next target for the whole school, and that will not be a good thing. But could not summon courage to face her, as she feared she would lose her best friend. And another reason was for that she could not say to Peggy that Peggy, you must stop teasing Wanda, because she was her best friend and she did not wish to lose her. However, Peggy's intention was never hurt to Wanda. But even Peggy was not cruel. She was also a very gentle girl. She loved. One day she saw some students teasing very small animal, and then she was very hurt. She felt like, why were they teasing to an animal? And then actually she was not realizing that she was also doing the same thing to somebody else. She perhaps thought that she was just a mad girl, and that's how she lies. And if she is lying, then they have the right to laugh at her. That's what the whole thing that she used to feel. Peggy was also not a cruel girl. Her intention was actually not to hurt Wanda. She did not wish to hurt Wanda. But since she felt that, why is she lying? Why is she telling that she is having 100 dresses, though she is wearing the same dress every day? Then why is she lying? She was curious and as to why Wanda had to lie that she had 100 dresses in her closet. Truth about the same 100 dresses unveiled on the result day of drawing competition. And the truth came to be known to everyone when the drawing competition was organized. The truth was unveiled. That means that the truth came in front of everybody. On the result day of drawing competition, the room was lined up with 100 drawings portraying different colors, different designs. And when the drawing competition was held that day, the whole room was filled with the designs of 100 dresses made by Wanda Petronsky. And that day when all of them saw it, then perhaps they were just astonished to see, and they perhaps felt that she was really having 100 dresses. Each so beautiful. That day she truly had 100 dresses all lined up, but in the classroom. At that moment, Peggy and Maddie, who were awestruck, realized the theory of 100 dresses and felt guilty about having treated her badly. And that day only, Maddie and Peggy also, they felt that they were actually wrong. She had beautiful dresses, but it was actually on the paper, and they were making fun of her poorness. And at that day only, they felt that they must say sorry to her. But actually, they did not get the time to say sorry to her, because before they said sorry to her, she had left America and she has went back to some different place. So this was the whole story, and I'll be sharing the PDF of this story also. So you're going to learn from the PDF, and you're going to you'll find some words also. Let's learn new words from this chapter. You'll find this word incredulously. That means showing unwillingness to believe. Incredulous means what? When you see something very much surprising, oh my god, I cannot believe it. Like Wanda's 100 dresses, beautiful dresses, when all of them must have seen the drawing of 100 dresses, they would not have believed it. Oh my god, she can make such beautiful drawings. Courteous means polite, respectful, somebody who is very polite to everybody, somebody who is respectful to others is a courteous person. Stolidly means what? Very calm, very peaceful, very composed in manner, very good in behavior. So that person would be called what? Stolidly. Dependable and showing little emotion and animation. Shrieks. Shriek means what? It's a kind of noise that is made by people, that is screaming noise. When you you see in the horror movies, suddenly when the character sees the ghost, then they have a loud noise, and that loud noise is what? That is known as scream. Now let's find out the next few words. We'll be learning some words over here, because every chapter has some beautiful words, and this one is also having so many. Bullies, someone who hurts thee and or frightens someone else often over a period of time. Like Wanda was bullied by Peggy, not Maddie. Maddie was just a bay watcher. Maddie just used to stand there, and she used to just see everything. She never bullied her, but Peggy used to bully her. Peggy used to make fun of her. So even you'll find some of your friends also like that. They would be, you'll find that quite often they are bullying somebody. they are making fun of somebody. So someone who hurts or frightens someone else often over a period of time and forcing them to do something that they do not want to do. That person is what actually bully, and they were the act of doing that is what bullying. Mistreated, treat someone badly. Mistreated is what? When you treat someone badly, that is called mistreatment. So the kind of treatment that Peggy used to give to Wanda, that was actually a kind that was actually a mistreatment. Shuddered means what? Shake or tremble. Like if something fearful happens in front of you, then what do? You start shuddering, you start shaking, you start trembling. So that is called what? Shuddered. Disguised, when you actually try to be somebody else and try to hide your identity, that is known as what? Disguise. Conceal means what? That means hide. So disguise is what? When someone tries to conceal or someone tries to hide his identity, so that is known as what? Disguise. Scarcely, hardly, barely. This word means what? Scarcely means what? Very little, you can say. Hardly or barely. Trimmings means what? Decoration. Peggy's dresses, when it was given to Maddie, then Maddie's mother used to trim it and she used to decorate it for her, and that's how she used to disguise it, that none of them would come to know that it was one of the Peggy's dresses. Sash, a long strip of or loop cloth worn over one shoulder or round the waist, especially a part of uniform or official dress, pretend not genuine. You must have seen those Miss India competitions. In all those competitions, you will find a very long stripe from their one shoulder going towards the other's end of their body. And that is actually known as what? Sash. Admiration means what? Respect and praise for somebody. So that is known as what? Admiration. And gasped means what? Catch one's breath with an open mouth owing to pain or astonishment. Suppose what happens, you're standing in front of someone and that person is actually feeling a pain, and just suddenly takes a long breath, and that you are able to feel that thing. So that long breath is what? Gasped. Window sill, les is actually kind of Almira, self, that you all must be having in your houses, and that where you are keeping your books, where you are keeping your things, that is called what? Les. Window sill, les or sill forming the bottom part of window. Window sill is what? Actually, the bottom part of the window where you can place few things. Dazzling. Extremely impressive, beautiful or skillful. When something you will find very much beautiful, very impressive, that you would say it is just dazzling. So dazzling is what? It actually expresses something to be very beautiful. Drizzling, it's a very light rain. Shower, you can also say. Hurried means very quick steps. Lavish means gorgeous, very beautiful. Murmured, to say something in a very low voice that only a single person can hear, not anybody else. Admiringly, in a way that shows respect or warm approval. Admiringly means what? It's a way that shows like you're respecting somebody. So that is called what? Admiring. So thank you. This was the end of the chapter. This chapter, the 100 dresses part 1. And today we'll have a grammar lesson also at 10 o'clock. So thank you everybody. And after this, the question answer I'll be sharing over here. And you all are going to do that question answer, and you all are going to submit it at 4 p.m. today in the WhatsApp group. So thank you everyone.